Okay, today we're going to learn Russian spiral. This is a great technique to learn. It's very adaptable to other sizes of beads and shapes of beads. But today we're going to do our basic. So for this project, we're going to work in 11 O-seed beads and 8 O-seed beads, two contrasting colors. And then you'll need about 50 4-millimeter fire polish crystals, which we're going to put on here. You're going to need a clasp. I'm going to use this little toggle. And I like putting little bead caps on the end of the work, which finishes it off nice. Of course, you'll need beading needles. I'm using size 10 beading needles and 8-pound crystal fire line. You can thread whatever you like to thread with, Nymo, 1G, all the other threads that are out there, Silamide, you can use that too, but of course my favorite is Fireline. So you're going to thread your needle on and I give myself about, I don't know, 2 full arm lengths to start, maybe about 6 feet of Fireline. For this purpose, I'm just going to just cut a little bit off though to get you started. Thread your needle. And then lay out your beads. So you need to put a little pile of 8 O-seed beads out. This is an opaque turquoise. And your 11 O-seed beads. And this is a rainbow silver lined dark emerald. To start with, you're going to pick up 1 8 O-seed bead and 2 11 O-seed beads. And you're going to do that 3 times. You want 3 sets of them. So now we have a total of 3 8 O-seed beads and 6 11 O's. And we'll pull them down to our tail. Leave yourself about a 12-inch tail, 10 or 12-inch tail, because you're going to use that to finish putting your clasp on at the end. I'm going to tie this in a knot, just a quick little overhand knot. Now I'm not going to be finishing this project, so I'm not wasting my fire line, so I have a shorter tail right now, but when you start your project, make sure you start with a good amount of thread. We just want to tie this in a knot, or you could just circle around with your needle and thread. So we get a circle, overhand knot. And then you want to take your needle so it should look like this. You have a little circle. And you want to get away from the knot. So sew with your needle and just go through, and you want your needle coming out the 2 11 O-seed beads. We will always be coming out of our 11 O-seed beads in between. Pull it through. Now we can start. When you begin this project, it's going to look a little strange. We're going to start it flat first, and then we're going to pull it into a little cup, and it actually is a tubular spiral technique, and we are spiraling and sewing in this direction. We're not sewing vertical, more on a horizontal plane. So, to begin with, we have our little circle of beads. We're going to pick up an 8-0 and 2 11 O's. And we're going to use our big 8-0 beads as our marker, because we're always going to be sewing into the 11 O-seed bead right after the big one, so that our needle comes out in between the 2 11 O's. Pull that tight. You need to work with tight, even tension. Now, I'm holding on to my work, and I'm looking for my next marker, which is my 8-0. And I'm going to pick up an 8 and 2 11s. And I'm going to skip over the 8-0 and sew into the 11. Russian spiral, like I said earlier, is really adaptable. It's nice if you start with an 8-0 and 11-0 to begin with until you see the pattern develop. Then I'll show you other examples later of what happens when you change the size of the bead.